MDMA is a selective serotonin releaser. It also prevents the reuptake of serotonin, but its unique property, what no other drug that we know of does, is selectively release serotonin. MDMA, contrary to a lot of things you might hear, does not have direct action on any other neurotransmitter in the brain. Dopamine, norepinephrine, endorphins, it just releases serotonin. However, there are secondary or cascading effects that result from the serotonin release, which do include effects of increased dopamine and norepinephrine. Who has heard of oxytocin? Yeah, this is a really educated crowd, right? We're at a college, of course. Oxytocin is the empathy, bonding hormone that's released during childbirth and breastfeeding that helps mothers bond with their children. Interestingly, MDMA also causes somehow the release of oxytocin, which is partially responsible for the empathy effects, one of the effects that makes it so compelling for users. One thing that a lot of people don't understand is the way that the serotonin system is structured in the brain. Most people, when they think of brain cells, they think of these little things, one thing here, one there, and they're like microscopic, and they're connected, you know, in a network. And many are like that, but serotonin cells aren't. Serotonin cells are long and spindly, and all the cell bodies that exist in the raphe nuclei. And the dendrites point down into the spinal column, into the nervous system. And then the axons innervate the whole brain in like these Christmas tree-like branches. If you stretched a serotonin cell out on a table in front of you, it might be a foot long with like all these branches in it. So a lot of scientists call serotonin a globalizing neurotransmitter. It kind of modulates the release of many other neurotransmitters in the brain. What MDMA does is it binds to the serotonin reuptake transporters. These are molecules that exist on the membrane of the axon. And normally, these molecules are responsible for scooping up the serotonin from the synapse and bringing it back into storage. What MDMA does is it binds to these reuptake transporters that normally scoop the serotonin back in, causing them to work in reverse, flooding the synapse with serotonin. Serotonin is active when it's bound to receptors on the dendrites of nearby cells. And serotonin, when it binds to a receptor, sends a message to that cell that tells it, based on the accumulation of all of its receptors, whether or not it should fire an electrical signal down its axon and release its own neurotransmitter, whatever it happens to be at the time. And these receptors, to complicate things more, can be either excitatory or inhibitory. And we know that there's about 15 or so different types of serotonin receptors. Some of them are excitatory, some of them are inhibitory. And therapists say that one of the magical things about MDMA is that it appears that these receptors are excitatory and inhibitory in all the right places. So we know it reduces activity in the amygdala. Where fear is processed, and so the receptors are most likely inhibitory for serotonin in the amygdala, but in the forebrain, they're excitatory. So while it reduces fear and anxiety, it doesn't numb you out like benzodiazepines, other anti-anxiety drugs that we have aren't good for therapy because they also kind of make you a bit loopy because they reduce the potential for higher thought, learning new things, seeing things in a new way, but MDMA kind of has the opposite effect. It makes the person very alert, increases their memory retention, they remember everything from the therapy session, and that's based on its sort of unique pharmacology.